how sermons interact in their sense. So one thing we'll see a lot from DJ is using a lot of forward airs mid combo just to cause a tech-up situation where most people will tech up. Oh no, the Bowser.
The Bowser is here, and I thought he was using Fox McCloud. So this is for the fans, of course. Everybody loves to see DJ Nintendo's Bowser. Bowser, considered a low-tier character in Super Smash Bros. Melee, or possibly even mid-tier.
Yeah, most people would say low-tier, but no, it's always about the character of the player, and not the character of the character. We've seen a lot of players with quote-unquote subpar or underdeveloped characters be able to do things.
True.
And he's going to have plenty of knowledge in this matchup, because he's played against players like Scar, Hax, Warrior Knight as well.
Mando, and the list just goes on. But yeah, in this matchup, Captain Falcon, if he were to get one grab or even a neutral air on Bowser, or any aerial in general,
it leads to a world of hurt.
Yes, because Bowser, he has the weight that allows you to just combo him across the stage.
And of course, with a huge hurt box, you're just begging to be hit over and over again.
Absolutely. Nice. I like this by Jesus. So recognizing that Bowser usually goes for those up B's out of shield, up B. Nice! Neutral air to knee. So the up B out of shield, it has invincibility, and if you get hit by it, it pops the opponent up. And a character like Captain Falcon, since he's a fast follower, after he gets popped up, he gets knocked on the ground, giving Bowser an opportunity for possibly a tech chase, depending on the percent.
So we're seeing good presence of mind in Jesus after getting hit with that up B. Air dodges to the platform where Bowser can't continue. But of course, we're going to see DJ try and use those up B's near the, I'd say, you know, 4 or 5 counter lengths away from the stage's end. Just in case he doesn't connect, he can just go directly to the ledge and not have to worry about getting punished afterwards.
Oof. DJ's still in a good position to get this edge guard, but good job by Jesus. And, okay, looks like Jesus is not usually ready for those back throws out of the side B.
Nope, it's also about having that character knowledge and magic knowledge, and not too many people play solid Bowsers. I mean, last year, I don't even think, was DJ at EVO last year? I don't
DJ Nintendo was not at EVO last year.
So, I mean, we have Gimme Fish in the building. Of course, we also see players like Eiffelman occasionally play Bowser. But when it comes to, you know, who holds the Bowser crown right now, most people say it's still DJs.
This is true. Nice reverse knee. Wait, this just might be 2 stocks each. Yes, it sure is.
Solid press the mind of Jesus again. He's trying to get these hitboxes perfectly. So he's properly spacing, or even Mac is looking for the reverse knee to close the stock. Gets for it, but still was able to close it out afterwards.
Oh, DJ Nintendo missing that tech chase as Jesus opted for a tech in.
Also, we're seeing some of the, pun not intended, the power of Bowser. Because these hits are adding up extremely quickly, with the exception of the up these DJ's using pretty often. He's scaling pretty well here and there.
No. One thing I do like that I'm seeing from Jesus is that he's recognizing when DJ Nintendo's on the platforms, he's going to keep trying to toss out those up airs. DJ Nintendo needs to be careful against Jesus, because you don't want to get caught by those up airs by Captain Falcon.
Right.
That'll lead to a stop.
Right.
Oh, he baited out the up B. That was good.
Yep, and DJ actually committed to that time. I guess he was expecting an aerial to be thrown earlier instead of the patience, so.
Oh. Another up B. And the good thing about this stage is that the platforms allow DJ to get a tech chase off of those up Bs after he hits them.
Yep. And DJ, of course, cognizant of earlier situations when Jesus tried to jump the top platform and air dodge out.
Oh,
wait for it.
This is the third time that DJ Nintendo has done that combo, and yet Jesus has not DI'd it appropriately. Every time, going all the way to the left. You need to try to hold up and towards the stage.
You know, it's like I said before, it's also a matter of just having that knowledge of the matchup and what to do in certain situations, and well, this is a matchup that you're rarely going to see and get acclimated with. So.
Yep, and because of that, the unknown factor will come into play, giving DJ Nintendo an edge in this match. Wow, that was such a meaty up B as he got 17%. Wow, Jesus trying to force the DJ Nintendo off stage. Scary thing though is a character like Bowser, if he does get near the edge, and if he grabs the edge rather, and it does his get up attack, that can lead to Falcon being off stage, setting up for a potential forward smash. Good stuff. DJ Nintendo just slapping on offstage, almost looking like Sheik.
Yeah, it was not pretty there at all. That second jump was exhausted nearly immediately. DJ had to have a read that. Yeah, he's probably going to just panic and get back at ASAP. Look at that percentage of the down smash.
Oh, man. Again. Oof. See, DJ Nintendo just putting out hitboxes in the right spots where his opponent just might be. That was really... I like that by DJ. Just staying in the center, just waiting for Jesus to approach.
Yeah, I'm liking the choice from Jesus here with like the back airs, but he's got to space them better because when he is missing and misspacing them, he's getting punished for it hard with these upbeats.
Big time. Good forward tilt by DJ. Bowser's forward tilt has a great hitbox. Pretty deceptive. Oh, DJ Nintendo a little late on the draw. And now, here's Jesus' opportunity to get that solid combo, forcing Bowser off stage and taking the stock.
Showing some signs of life, definitely. One, you know, from Jesus right now, besides DI'ing that better, I need to see more grabs, getting that game going. The receiving commit from, I'd say, you know, half screen away with Raptor boost and Falcon kicks, you know, not always the optimal choice, but also spacing again is something he has to work on in this matchup.
Yeah.
I mean, that was a really, really well-placed nair there. He could have dash-danced away if an upbeat was coming, but overall, it's something he has to work on.
Yeah, even when he got that dare that he got on DJ Nintendo, he really needed that. It probably would have led to a stock, but he didn't out-cancel it. To make sure his L cancels are on point, and he needs to, like you said, use more grabs, because as you can see, DJ Nintendo is blocking most of the time.
Because he wants to get those upbeats out of shield, he's getting a lot of mileage out of it.
There it is, he's blocking again. Every time he sees that bubble, he needs to use that speed that Captain Falcon has. Get those grabs in, convert those into solid combos.
You see DJ basically stalking, holding down the stage, not letting Jesus in. At all.
Yeah, and the funny thing, if you notice, DJ Nintendo's being a little more mobile now. Nice. Tossing in that little moonwalk, allowing him to have his back turn as he grabs the edge. It's probably one of Bowser's fastest ways to grab the edge next to his upbeat. Nice. DJ Nintendo on the platform, but he uses the downbeat to immediately grab the edge, making it hard for Jesus to edge guard.
Yeah, Jesus didn't want to, he didn't want to challenge it.
Yeah, the hitbox is pretty big.
Also, I mean, at that percent, with this kind of deficit, I play the patient game. But again,
oh my gosh!
Forward smash.
Nice tech chase by DJ. Good job by Jesus trying to jump out of there. Goes for the moonwalk.
Don't go for style, go for substance. You're playing to win right now.
Oh, DJ again. With the side B into the side B again. 2-0 victory with the Bowser. Look at him.